What is an IP rating? Waterproof versus water resistant? Here's what the numbers really mean in those IP ratings. I'm Ealan Osborne, and this is Ecoustically Speaking. One of the biggest changes we've seen over the past 20 years has been the shift from listening to our favorite music and watching our favorite movies and TV shows inside to enjoying our media in the great outdoors while we exercise, commute, or just lounge outside on the deck. Consumers have had the ability to enjoy music on the go for decades, but do you remember how quickly you removed your headphones and Walkman and stuffed them inside of your coat or backpack at the first drop of rain or snow? The emergence of streaming media, smartphones, tablets, digital audio players, wireless earbuds, headphones, and speakers has caused a paradigm shift in our listening and viewing behavior. And this shift has also meant that manufacturers have had to figure out how to keep dust, sand, rain, snow, and wind from penetrating that equipment and ruining it. As a result, an industry standard developed by the International Electrotechnical Commission has been developed in order to qualify the precise level of protection from the elements that a given piece of gear can provide. Referred to as IP, ingress protection, or IPX rating, this standard can help a consumer choose the right product for their specific use case. Whether that's jogging in the rain with a pair of earbuds, listening to music at the beach, or even splashing around in the pool with a Bluetooth wireless speaker, there's an IP rating that's got you covered. The IP rating indicates the degree of an electrical or mechanical enclosure's resistance to various types of unwanted intrusion like dust, water, or sand. The reason for having an IP rating system is to ensure the safety of electrical and mechanical devices in the outdoors or other locations, which are obviously exposed to the elements, and ultimately to help a consumer select the right tool for the job. Instead of relying on ambiguous terms such as waterproof, water resistant, dustproof, which are just too general, the IP rating includes a numeric scale designed to provide a more precise measurement as to the degree of water or dust resistance a specific device might have. IP ratings are formatted with the letters IP followed by two digits. The first number represents resistance to solids like dust and sand. This varies from 0, no protection, to 6, full protection. The second digit applies to water or moisture resistance. It varies from 0, no protection, to 9, complete protection. This means the most secure devices, which are practically impervious to the elements, are rated IP69. I'm 42. Sometimes the first digit or the second digit is not included and instead has an X as a placeholder. The use of an X in the rating means the device has not been tested for this type of intrusion, solid or liquid. This might appear as IPX5 or IPX7. On the flip side, an IP6X rating would mean the device has been tested for dust resistance but not for water resistance. Make sense? In general terms, IP water ratings from 1 to 6, for example IPX4 or IPX5, are considered water resistant to varying degrees. This means that they can handle splashes of water but not full immersion in water. You can't throw one of these into the lake or drop it in a toilet without suffering consequences. Meanwhile, IP water ratings of 7 or higher are considered waterproof, again, on a scale. While a water rating of 7 can be submerged for up to 30 minutes in up to 3 feet of water, a rating of 8 or 9 can be submerged greater than 3 feet deep for extended periods. Although we do still strongly recommend not dropping your phone in a toilet, even if it's rated at IP69. Because as you may have guessed on this time on Earth, some smells just don't go away. If you're simply jogging in the rain, a pair of headphones with an IPX4 rating should be fine. But if you're bringing that portable Bluetooth speaker out in the canoe with you, look for an IPX7 rating or above in case it falls into the water. On the beach, a device with a 4 in the first digit might be okay for sand, but to be safe against dust, look for a 5, dust resistant, or a 6, dust proof in that first digit. As an example, IRL, in our founder Brian Mitchell's recent high-end Bluetooth speaker roundup, the DVLA Mania is only IPX4 rated. Minimal water resistance, right? The Soundbox Go steps up to IPX6, decent water resistance, while the Brain X is the only one that can actually be submerged in water with an IP57 rating. Huh? Is it clicking now? In some rare cases, you might also see a letter after the digits, IP65M or IP69K. This adds another environmental protection indicator, such as resistance to specific materials or hazards like oil or high voltages, or a specific manner in which the IP testing was conducted, for example, submersed in moving water. However, these letters are rarely used for consumer electronics. The following summarizes the commonly used IP or IPX rating designations you might encounter with consumer electronics, with details about the type of ingress testing and certification. Here we go. IPX0, no protection. IPX1, protects from condensation or vertically dripping water. IPX2 protects from sprays up to 15 degrees. IPX3 protects from sprays up to 60 degrees. IPX4 protects from splashing water from any direction. IPX5 protects from low-pressure water jets from any direction. IPX6 protects from high-pressure water jets in any direction. IPX7 protects when immersed in water for 30 minutes up to 3 feet deep. IPX8 protects when immersed in water over 3 feet deep for extended periods. IPX9 protects from high temperature and high pressure water jets from any direction, as well as full immersion over 3 feet deep for extended periods. Okay, I'm sure you can guess, IP0 means no protection. IP1 protects against solid objects larger than 2 inches or 50 millimeters in diameter. IP2 protects against solid objects larger than a half inch or 12.5 millimeters. IP3 protects against solid objects larger than a tenth of an inch or 2.5 millimeters. IP4 protects against solid objects larger than 0.04 inches or 1 millimeter. IP5 protects against dust or is considered dust resistant. IP6, no dust entry, dust proof, or dust tight. And honestly, dust tight is the best you can get, so you don't need to go beyond that. Although these ratings are most frequently seen on portable devices such as phones, speakers, and earbuds, you can also find IPX ratings on select TVs that carry IP ratings specifically for outdoor use. So, if you happen to be shopping for a portable or outdoor speaker, smartphone, or another device you plan to use outdoors or in the shower, its ability to resist the effects of dust and/or liquids is an important thing to take into consideration. So, be sure to check the IP rating to make sure it can withstand the elements. Otherwise, that super fun pool party might end in disappointing or even shocking results. You've been warned. And this concludes this episode of Ecoustically Speaking. Do you feel educated now? Did we miss anything? Do you feel more prepared for that rare occasion when IP ratings come up at your next trivia night at your local pub? If so, you're welcome. As always, to keep up on all things home audio, home theater, stereo hi-fi, gadgets, wearables, and tech, be sure to bookmark eCoustics.com. And honestly, as soon as this video is over, you should probably take the time to double check the IP rating of your most precious portable device. Maybe it has an IP7 rating and you don't need to freak out and put it in a bowl of rice overnight if you accidentally drop it in the toilet. Knowledge is power, my friends. Until next time.